something, something I can never be without, yeah. I'm in your coming, thought I was a man of my own will. It's been 2 years, I'm only a shadow of the good on me now. A breeze in my ear, cause you know I cannot see no audio. Feeling like home, but should it be like this? Locked up in your dome, you know I fight for you.
What's up, guys? Vinyl Vixen and Sim Shetty here at Rap Sesh. This week we are showcasing this Mustang GT. Rap that we are doing. We are almost done with it. Not quite there yet. So this rap is actually, this is our first time that we've used the Hexus HX 30,000 film. So this was a newer brand of high-tech film for us to try out. It's not a new film, it's just we haven't used it as far as color changes. So this was our first time working with this film, so we're gonna talk about our experience with that. A couple issues that we ran into with the car that we had to kind of impromptu fix. Which always happens. When we rip apart cars, we always find things that are broken.
I feel like every time I get into a car, I find two or three things at least, you know, that someone has past worked on the car that broke.
Right. And we always take photos and send a detailed list to our customers when we find damage. But a lot of the times we end up taking on the responsibility ourselves and fixing it.
Yeah.
And we do stuff that we're not even
Would rather give the customer back the car better than when it came to me.
Absolutely, especially if there's stuff that's broken.
Yeah.
Okay, so to start out, we actually did a full exterior wrap. Original paint color is a gloss red, you can see right here. Under these seals, what the original is. He wanted a matte metallic red that kind of had almost like a satin red chrome look to it.
Yeah.
Just something that looks
like
really unique.
Got like a anodized red kind of look.
Yeah, anodized, that works. So we did a full exterior wrap in that. Let's talk about, with that film specifically, what was some of the challenges that were different than what we normally use, because we've used like Oracal, we just did a Mustang in KPMF.
That's
a high tech.
I would say this film is right in between KPMF and Oracal. It's kind of has that thickness to it.
Yeah.
And it also has
really thick, really high tech.
Really high tech. So it's high tech, and the good thing about it is it doesn't have adhesive lines anywhere.
Yeah.
It does not make adhesive lines.
That's one thing I really like. Well, you can, but
it's very hard.
It's a lot harder to make adhesive lines and glue lines, which I absolutely hate.
Yeah.
So I did like that.
The challenges we were having, like you said, was it doesn't like to hold well. And so what you have to do is, what we figured is, you really have to just post heat this material
double
you normally post heat, because it's such a thick and rigid material that it just always wants to bounce back to its original state.
Even when you preheat it, like when we preheat a bumper panel, it took a lot longer
it takes a
just
lot
to
more
heat,
heat
it.
Yeah.
And that's probably because it's a lot thicker than a standard one, and it's a
thicker.
Very high tack. But we definitely had to tweak our methods a little bit.
You have to relieve things in more areas that you normally wouldn't.
One thing I didn't like specifically about the film is I couldn't hit a lot of like small 90 degree areas, like tight recesses. So like these hood vents right here, I work those and heat those in, post heat them and everything, and they want to bubble up. You know what I mean? And then like areas behind the fender, normally we wrap all the way in and down. This film would not go in and down and make that 90 degree turn. Door jams we had to do a little bit different.
And a couple of the bubbles though that we did have come up that we noticed, if you just heated it to where it was almost like gummy, like literally it's you're baking it onto the car pretty much, but you have to be careful because you can also gloss this film.
Yes.
But it does take an extreme amount of heat because now those bubbles are staying down.
What was nice was we had the car here for 2 weeks or so. We could see how it holds up over time, see what needs you know, the stuff we need to go back to and fix or post heat. Yeah. So that's one thing I really like about keeping cars a long time, especially when we're working with a new film. We'll try to do all the harder things at the very beginning
and then
watch how it holds up over the next week. And then we know if we need to make any adjustments in our install.
Yep.
The best like advice I can give you if you're trying a new film or if you're using this film specifically is like, when in doubt, seam it out.
Seam it out?
I should put that shit on a shirt.
When in doubt, well.
But like the bumper, normally we could do like a one piece bumper if I was using a low tack like Avery or Cheetah Wrap. This film, you have to do it in more pieces. You can't hit those crazy angles. So if you feel like it's having a hard time getting there, just seam
it. You should probably
make a nice clean seam on the body line and you won't deal with fail points
later.
You
can look at our bumpers and you wouldn't be able to tell that there's seams everywhere. But as long as you can hide your seams, you're fine. Even though we used more seams probably than we normally would have on a different film, they still look just as good because we were able to make it work. Yeah, you can hide them really well.
You just gotta plan it out and really strategize. I mean, these bumpers we spend like 6 to 8 hours
on just the bumper.
Doing it start to finish, prep, install, post heat, like everything. Yep. Lam stripping is huge on this. I highly recommend getting laminate strip and going around the edges and pinning them down.
Especially with this, the kind of film.
Yeah,
even just like Oracal, Hexas, KPMF, all the thicker films, they really like to bounce back.
So even like areas like this on your corners, like it's not that bad of an idea to just dab a little bit of primer. I'm not usually big on primer, but with this film, I think it helped a little bit. Or you can also use a laminate strip and you basically sling the corner and the tension's gonna hold that corner down. I use that all the time.
You stretch the lam strip over.
Lam strip's a must have.
If you're really having a hard time with a corner, that's a
basically
pretty
good fix. Pre-stretch a piece of lam strip around there, you're good to go.
Yeah.
But it looks really nice.
Yeah.
We're adding some gray accents on top of it. So we're doing a partial clear bra package in the Hexas Body Fence Satin. That's gonna go pretty much like up to about right here
about
on the
24
car.
24 inches.
Mm-hmm.
About 30, yeah.
And then we're doing a ceramic coating over the entire thing. So you're gonna have more scratch protection. This mat will no longer be porous with that coating on there. It's gonna be a lot easier to maintain.
Also,
it'll look a lot nicer.
It makes it look deeper.
It does.
It really deepens the color and makes it super rich. It looks really
nice.
And
a question I get all the time with Ceramic Pro is it gonna turn the film gloss? You know, because this is a matte. It does make it just a tiny bit shinier, but it makes the color
look
better.
To where you even realize that it's still matte.
It looks way better though when you coat it, honestly, and it lasts longer. So I highly recommend coating your wraps.
When I take cars apart, like I said, I find things all the time that are broken or missing or something like that. Well, in this case, the last people to take his bumper off decided to just
epoxy.
They broke it, which is, the tab is still in the piece, and they decided to just glob an entire amount of rubber cement or epoxy inside this piece and just slap the bumper on. So the bumper literally had no tabs. They're literally epoxied in here. On this car in particular, I found that the front bumper had been removed because he has a turbo system in this car that was installed, and so they had removed the front bumper. And I don't know if it was them for sure, but that might have been the last people who touched it. So what they did instead of, on these cars, these clips on these front bumpers right here, they're very fragile. And this isn't the only car they're very fragile on, but these Mustangs in general,
it's known for breaking.
They're very known for breaking. I haven't broken any myself, luckily, but they are very well known.
And that's that tab right here, this whole piece.
These clips are what actually clips into the fender. And so what they did, they ripped those tabs off, and once you rip those tabs off, there's no way of putting the bumper back on.
Nothing to attach.
There's nothing to attach, yeah. So what they did was just went in, got a couple tubes of JB Weld and just filled the entire thing full of JB
and
just put the bumper on, which is a terrible way to put a bumper on because not only this car having a turbo system and an intercooler, it's going to be removed one day again. And
someone's going to be unlucky.
And someone's going to be unlucky like me to find it.
And then volunteer to fix it.
And then I'm going to have to spend a bunch of time and fix it. So don't do this because It's not fun to mess with. I actually had to drill these out and Dremel for about 30, 40 minutes just to get to the bolts to take this piece off. So what we did is I removed the parts, and what we did is we went and bought these quick latches, and you can buy them off Amazon or there's a couple other websites that sell them, but they're pretty much it's kind of like a race car thing. But all it is literally just a post that you bolt right into the fender. And then this tab, you just have to drill a hole in the bumper and put this tab in there, and it just clicks right onto the car. So it's a super easy, clean fix, and it also gives it kind of like a race car look.
It looks cool, like it actually matches the wrap.
So I went and I got these quick latch kits, and I also bought the spring that goes on it, so it makes it a little easier to come off.
How much was that?
That was about like $50.
Okay.
For the quick latch.
$50 so far, yeah.
It's a $50 fix. So I went out and bought one of these step bits. I didn't have one on hand. And I was able to get a nice clean hole drilled in there.
It's a removable solution.
It's also a removable solution.
It looks cool.
And it's also easy to remove.
Yes, you know, it's like easier than how it originally was.
But it also looks really nice. It's flush, it's clean, and it holds really well.
And what did you spend? Maybe an extra hour or two total, like drilling it?
Oh yeah, it was about an hour install. Okay. And honestly, it probably wouldn't even take that long. I was taking my time, so.
You were doing five other cars,
So it really wasn't that bad. The lineup is probably the hardest part, getting the, you know, the actual adjustment. Mm-hmm. But other than that, it was nice easy fix. Yeah.
Make sure to check out our Facebook and Instagram. That is Vinyl Vixen Wraps and Wrap Sesh AZ if you want to see all the daily fun here at the shop. Always got a lot of cool stuff going on. Fun stuff? Not that kind of stuff.
No. God, it was a movie reference. Okay. Don't put that in there.
I think you should put that in.
It was for Night at the Roxbury.
That's why it's so funny.
Okay.
I don't know what to do with my hands.
What?
Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe if you dig the Wrap Sesh vibe.
Whoa!
That's dancing.
You're like doing a full-on dance move over here.
That's what dancing is. I'm not gonna half-ass it. Are you ready for the dance move now?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, ready?
Yes. Yeah.
Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. You dig the Wrap Sesh vibe. See you next week. Whoa, ho, ho, fade away.
So the bumper literally had no tabs. They're literally epoxied in here. And hey, good, how are you? I think it was HX 3000 though. It's not 30,000 because I just looked at the book.
Ah, shit.
I think it's 3000. So, I forgot where it was, but okay.
So we're taking off the bumper, which is a normal thing we do for a color change, yeah? Yeah, say yes.
Hold on. I'm trying to think of something that I was told. I was going to
say,
I was
literally. We'll just do what feels.
What feels?
Feel it. You gotta feel it.
Can I just jiggle like this?
Yeah, but do it like excessively.
No. No.
Yes.